actually, the Honey Blowout story is my sister, who's one of those like naturalistas, YouTube girls, mixologists, was like mixing something up in her kitchen and she brought it to me. And I took the formula and I perfected it. So before I actually like launched it this year, I was using it in a salon for 2 years on my clients, just kind of mixing it, playing with it to see what formula was right for my clients. So the Honey Blowout is a treatment for all hair types. You apply it before and you have the option to apply it after your first shampoo. So this first slide in your pamphlet, if, when you first open it, you'll see how to use it. Before I go into how to use it, let me show you. So today, the sale is, so today one bottle is 12, online the gold tops go for 19, your big bottle is 35, and then I'm running a special if you buy four, and a big one is 65 for the set. So we'll go back over there. So the Honey Blowout is a treatment for all hair types, and the benefits are, it's a heat protectant, it promotes shine, protects color-treated hair, tames frizz, locks in moisture, is salon tested, and yes, it's unisex. It can be used on both men and women. My photographer back there, Daryl, he actually uses it on his locks.
I do.
So it has been tested across the board, and all hair types have been able to use it. What you want to do is you want to wet the hair down first, apply Honey Blowout, leave it on, and then you put your sulfate-free shampoo on over top of it. I recommend sulfate-free shampoo. If you do not use sulfate-free shampoo, it's even better than to use Honey Blowout because you want a protectant on the hair. Let's talk about the protection factor. So honey is a natural balancer.
How much will you use?
So if you're using it, so the process I just explained is called pre-poo. Pre-poo is a term where you actually treat the hair before you shampoo it. When you treat the hair before you shampoo it, you're giving the hair the moisture that it needs first when you go to wet it. Shampoos remove a lot of the oils and strips our hair. It has something in there called an SLS agent. I'm going to break it down on another slide. Where sulfate shampoos have sulfate and it removes a lot of oils from the hair. So a lot of the shampoos that we're already using has that in it. We want to give the hair a protection and a barrier on the hair to protect the natural oils. So Alex, to answer your question, anywhere from a half an ounce to an ounce when you're doing a pre-poo, if somebody has more hair, you use more. So you gauge it on how much hair the client has. Any more questions before I move along? Because I'm seeing some questions.
Are you looking for a lather when you apply to your lather?
Your first shampoo, you're not going to get a lather because you have the Honey Blowout on there first. And you don't, that lather is actually, the lack of lather is actually locking in the natural oils in the hair. So you're not going to get a whole lot of lather on your first shampoo. Your second shampoo, maybe your regular shampoo, you're going to get a lather. Also, if the client has dry scalp, so the whole point of Honey Blowout is to lock in the natural oils. So if your client has dry scalp, you want to treat the dry scalp first. So you're going to wet the hair down. You can do your dandruff shampoo first or your antiseptic. Treat the dry scalp first and then do your Honey Blowout process. Because the Honey Blowout is all about locking in the natural oils on the hair to get to natural shine, sealing, protecting the hair. Because you should have like a keratin-like result when you go to flat iron and blow dry out the hair.
So. If you shampoo 3 times, should you use the other hair for 3 times? Should
it be the second time? Because the shampoo that you shampoo with
behind the initial mixture, like
kind of like the hand wash. Yes, so if you shampoo 3 times, if you're starting out, usually before I started doing my Honey Blowout process, I would do what I call number one was my cleansing, then I would do my dandruff shampoo, then I would do my hydrating. I totally remix the way I shampoo hair now. I do my dandruff first, and I don't shampoo it. I used to shampoo the hair 3 times, now I just shampoo it twice, and I do conditioner. Because the hair needs more conditioner, and it needs more moisture than it does the shampoo. Shampoo is only to cleanse away what we don't need from the hair. We don't need to be shampooing the hair 3 and 4 times. You're taking away all the oils the client needs. And then you find yourself grabbing for all your poundage, your, you know, all of your styling tools, your styling agent. is you're trying to put the shine back into the hair because you depleted it out with the shampoos. So I honestly recommend you can try this, but I say if a client has a dryness problem, address that first. So address that first, put your Honey Blowout on. Anything that's gonna remove the oils, do all of that first, and then put your Honey Blowout on. Because the Honey Blowout is gonna replenish the oils that you took out and also balance the hair. Did that answer your question? So here in your pamphlet, you see the pH scale. So pH is the measure of acid or alkaline in any manner. Everyone remember the pH scale from school, so I'm gonna quickly go through it. pH scale goes from 1 to 14, 1 being more acidic, 14 being more alkaline. The pH of hair, the hair's natural pH range is a 4.5 to a 5.5 range. Honey, the pH of honey by itself is an acidic level of 3. Honey Blowout, the whole mixture is under 7, which is a pH level of 6. So it's always going to keep your hair in this acidic pH balance range. So when the hair stays pH balanced, that's when you get your benefits of preserving color, locking in moisture. You're not getting breakage over time. Breakage comes from dryness. The reason why people's hair break off, color depletes the hair. All these things that we do to the hair, we gotta keep it moisturized and balanced. So when you balance the hair, now you're keeping it stronger and healthier over time. Any questions about the pH scale, pH level? So blowout is one use that you can use it for when you go to blow out the hair. The other use you have for it is co-washing. How many of you are familiar with the term co-wash? So co-wash is basically when you cleanse the hair with conditioner. A lot of clients are getting into co-wash because there's products on the market that are showing them, and then you know you go into the whole YouTube thing where people are showing clients how to cleanse their hair with conditioner. So if you have a client, usually clients that wear their hair like this, they wear the blow out and they wear the curly hair, and they wear their hair naturally curly. You can co-wash their hair, but what I say here and in your pamphlet under each segment, I have a little quote where I put my own suggestions. So when co-washing, I recommend a sulfate-free or tea tree shampoo once a month. So with Honey Blowout, what I feel like it does is it opens you up to other markets where before where you wouldn't co-wash, or before if somebody comes in naturally curly and you say, you know, I'm not sure what to do with your hair, well, I don't have a product for your hair. And with Honey Blowout, you do have a product for their hair. You do have something that can address their curls. If you go on Instagram, follow me at Honey Blowout, you'll see clients who have used it on their hair and have worn it naturally curly. They say it enhanced their curls. I have clients who have used it on their color treated hair and it says it makes their color look more enhanced. So even before you get to the blowout process, you'll see the results on their hair and you'll see the results in their natural curl. And they will still follow up with their curly pudding or gels or whatever they use. But they want to, again, our first responsibility when you're using Honey Blowout is you're balancing the hair. And when you're keeping the hair balanced, again, I can't stress it enough. You're maintaining the shine, you're maintaining its moisture, it's less prone to break, especially for your regulars that come every week. My regulars that come every week, before I started using my Honey Blowout process, and I mean, we can be honest, everybody has their stress points in their hair. Some people got them in here. Some people is their edges. Some people is the nape of the neck. Some people hair is one side longer than the other. You don't know why one side won't grow all the way down. You will see that Honey Blowout will begin to prevent that over time. You won't see that as often. For me, I say hair is fragile. It's no magic treatment or one thing that can fix all, but it's things that we can do to prevent our clients from having damage long term. Does that make sense? So you can also use it on your extension hair. So usually when extension hair comes, 9 times out of 10 is usually soil. So if it's soil, you're gonna go ahead and the same way you would do it with your dandruff shampoo. You're gonna cleanse the extensions first, put your Honey Blowout on, leave it on, and put whatever shampoo you use over top of it. Because I know with weave hair, you have like, I use a smoothing shampoo. And I can show y'all what I use. So on weave hair, I use sleek shampoo. I also use the sleek conditioner. So when I do my Honey Blowout process in the salon, I wet them down, I put on Honey Blowout. This is my number one sulfate-free shampoo of choice, Caracare sulfate-free shampoo. I wet them down, I put this on. This is if they don't have a dandruff issue. I wet them down, I put Honey Blowout on. I work it through, I let it sit on for a minute. I use my sulfate-free shampoo. I use this twice, I rinse them. Then I use my sleek conditioner. When they're not getting a treatment, this is just for a regular blowout service. And the reason why I use sleek conditioner, I like a sealing, smoothing conditioner. Now if they're getting a treatment, I just use Honey Blowout and then I rinse it. Treatment 30 minutes under the dryer, I use that last and then I rinse it.
You use the Honey Blowout treatment on the actual extended hair?
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm talking about
just natural, regular.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
But I have put Honey Blowout on my extension hair and put it in the cap and threw it in the dryer, especially for hair that's like dry and wants to be replenished. So I want y'all to think about. I'm seeing like question marks on your face. I want y'all to think about Honey Blowout like when we have an iPhone. Think about it as your eye conditioning. The only thing you want to do with it first, all the time, you always want to put it on after you wet the hair. And you always want to put it on after you depleted the oils from using a dandruff shampoo. Because you have to keep the hair balanced. Well, I strongly suggest, I'm going to say what you have to do. I strongly suggest that you keep the hair balanced. And honey is a natural balancer.